Hey guys, George at SoundTraxx here, and in today's Back to Basics segment, we're going to talk about addressing. Short, long, four-digit, two-digit, what does all this mean? So let's get started. Now first off, let's define the address. Now the address is the number to which the information is being sent to. Much like a house address, the information is being sent there. Your mail goes to your home address. In this case, the DCC commands are being sent to the number address. Now the address is set by you as the user. And this can be a number that's either on the locomotive or a number that you use in your mind. In many cases, to make it easy to remember, we use the number that's on the locomotive. Now in early DCC systems, they only could talk to addresses 1 through 127. And so this became labeled as a two-digit address or basic address. Now the short address or the two-digit address is stored in CV1. Now this is a number again between 1 and 127 that you can store in your decoder. Now later integrations of DCC systems allowed us to be able to talk to a full four-digit address. In this case, we'll call it the long or the extended address. Now this is a number between 0001 and 9999. And this has to do with the way the digital signal is being sent, as why the two-digit address is 1 through 127. Now some DCC systems limit which address you can talk to. For example, Digitraxx, in many of their systems, your two-digit address is only 1 through 99, so addresses 100 through 127 become lost. Now future versions of the software allow you to talk to that. But NCE, however, on the other hand, 1 through 127 is considered a short address. Now when you're looking at this digitally, the long address or the extended address is stored in CV17 and 18 through a somewhat complicated mathematical algorithm that the good news is most DCC systems do that calculation for you, so you don't need to do it. Now that's stored in CV17 and 18. Our short address or basic address is stored in CV1. How do we know which address we're using? Well, CV29 has a bit that tells the decoder which address is active. So if the bit is off, you're talking to the two-digit or the short address. If the bit is on, you're talking to the extended or the long address. Now, when setting your address, you can use your command station. Now, you can do this on the programming track or you can do it on the main. So when I'm going through on this power cab, I can program on the main line to talk to address 3, and I can set this to any long address I want. Now, the biggest thing to remember when you're programming on the main line is that the decoder is going to ignore changes to the active address when it's on the main line, because it doesn't want you to accidentally lose control of your decoder when you're trying to program something else and maybe you hit the wrong button. But you can change from one address type to the other on the main line. Now, the programming track has no such limitations, so when you're setting an address on the programming track, it's assuming that you're intending to make that command. So worst case, you can always take it, and if, let's say for argument's sake, if you did hit something wrong, you can always take it back to the programming track, either read the CVs or program the CVs directly to override what was in there, so that that way you can gain control of your locomotive back. So once you understand this and you can gain the information, you can now control your decoder and set the address confidently like a pro.